Hi, I'm Dave Blumenthal with the Green Mountain Club. Welcome to our series of instructional videos on map and compass navigation. In this segment, I'll talk about what are the most important things to look for on any map that you bring with you when you're hiking. The first thing is the map's revision date. It's usually in the fine print somewhere, perhaps on the legend, and hopefully it's pretty recent. The date of a map's printing or revision is very important because it's an indication of how up-to-date or current the map is. And if you get into a confusing or ambiguous situation when you're on the trail, it's good to know whether the map is generally up-to-date, you know, that it's been up-to-dated sometime in the last 5 years or so, or whether the map, like some government maps, is 20, maybe even 30 years old. Lots of things can change on the ground in 20 or 30 years. And if you know the map is that old, then you can treat what you learn from the map with a grain of salt. The next thing to look for on any map is the contour interval. The contour interval is not the same on all maps. And even if you have a lot of experience having hiked with maps in lots of different places, your intuition about the steepness of a slope might not be accurate for the map that you're using if the contour interval is different. So take a look for that. Often in the fine print or near the scale of the map. The next thing to look for on any map is the scale. It may look like a small ruler and it may have units in feet or miles or kilometers. It gives you a way of judging distance. If you want to know how far something is on the map, one thing you can do is take a piece of string or a piece of grass and curve that piece of string or grass to conform to the usually irregular wavy position of the trail, and then stretch it out onto the scale so that you can determine the correct distance that you are interested in. The last thing that's always good to look for on a map is the compass rose, or an indication of which way north is. That's critical when you go to orient your map, which I'll discuss later. The map may also have an indication of what the angle of magnetic declination is, which is also important to note. In later segments, I'll talk about how to orient a map, read contour lines, and follow a bearing. For right now, enjoy your hikes.